We are at home cooking with Miss Brenda D. So welcome from Miss Brenda D and our family.
Hello, everyone. How y'all doing on this nice, beautiful day? Today, we're making classic stuffed bell peppers, y'all. Yes, and here are our ingredients. Here, I'm preparing my bell peppers. Okay, what I'm gonna do is cut off the tops of my bell pepper. And I'm also gonna remove the seeds and the membranes out of peppers. I'm going to finish preparing my bell peppers. I'm going to be right back. Okay, y'all, I have finished preparing my bell peppers. So now I'm going to place them in my pot of hot water to blanch them. I'm going to blanch them for like 4 to 5 minutes, and then I'm going to remove them from my pot. Okay, my peppers have been blanched, and now I'm removing them from my pot. Here I'm showing y'all how they supposed to be when you take them out of the pot. They have to have a little spring to them. As y'all can see, I'm showing you. Okay, I'm going to finish removing these, and I'm going to be right back. Now it's time to prepare our meat filling. Here I'm adding my tomato sauce, my onion powder, garlic powder, black pepper, salt, breadcrumbs. I decided to add another can of tomato sauce and my instant rice. And we're gonna mix this up together. And now we're gonna stuff our bell peppers. Okay, I have already prepared some. I'm showing you how I stuff mine. Just stuff it to the capacity. I overstuffed mine, y'all. Okay, y'all, I'm gonna place these in a 365 degree oven for 45 minutes. Here, I have placed some chopped bell peppers. I use some of the tops to my bell peppers that I cut off. I cut them in tiny pieces, and then I'm adding a little onion powder and a little salt and black pepper. Letting you know, the onion powder and the salt and the black pepper is optional. Some people just put just tomato sauce on theirs and it still turns out delicious. Okay, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna let this simmer for about 20 minutes and then your sauce is good to go. My stuffed bell peppers are all ready, and so what I'm doing now, I'm draining some of the juices out of my bell peppers, and I'm gonna do each one as so. Here, we're topping our stuffed bell peppers with our tomato sauce. Oh yes, make sure to make extra sauce for your stuffed bell peppers. When you cut them open and just spread some of that sauce on there, y'all, it is so, so good. Here, I'm adding just a little cheese on top. I'm just showing you how these can be done. You do not have to do it this way, but I'm showing you that you can add a little cheese on top of your favorite cheeses. Okay, I'm gonna pop these in the oven just for the cheese to melt because everything is ready and good to go. So we're gonna be right back with the final result. Okay, y'all, we are back. I'm just showing y'all how these turn out. Y'all, they were so, so delicious. I hope y'all enjoy this recipe. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. And please don't forget to hit that notification bell so y'all can get our new and upcoming videos. And to all my new viewers and subscribers, you are welcome, welcome, welcome to our channel. Okay, y'all. As always, I'm gonna say y'all have a blessed day and bye-bye for now. Love y'all. Stay safe and be blessed. Okay, y'all, I got my grandson Brent here in the kitchen with me, and he's gonna try these stuffed bell peppers, y'all. Tell everyone hello, Brent.
Hello.
Okay, y'all. Okay, go ahead and taste it. How you like it, Brent?
That's a hit.
Okay, y'all. He says that's a hit. Okay, y'all. We're going to let y'all go. And till next time, y'all have a blessed day.
And bye-bye for now.
Bye-bye for now, y'all.